So this morning, our welcome comes to us from David Martin, well-known member of St Matthew's congregation and part of our community in Albury, and also from Daxel.
Good morning and welcome to our service from St Matthew's Albury. Our building remains closed, but we are able to share in this service readings, reflections, music, all of the things that bring us together and unite us as a community. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you, David. And thanks a lot, Daxel, as well. So we are in the garden at St Matthew's. Of course, as you can see, that the gates are still closed. And the church itself is closed. There it is, in all its beauty. Well, of course, our hearts are very much open. And in this week, as we are thinking about the Ascension and looking forward to Pentecost, I'm thinking about things that give us a lift and towards being outside in the sunshine, beautiful, but also it's acts of kindness, I think, that really matter when we're thinking about giving us a lift in this period of ascension and giving other people the sort of lift they need. And we do that not just by thoughts and prayers, but also by loving action. And so these care rugs. Yes. We have some wonderful people, don't we, have made these.
So people know that they're being thought of and bringing warmth to their days and bringing
colour. Yeah. So it's lovely to have Mary Lou back again, of course, manning our office. There we are.
Hey ho.
Hey ho. And giving people a lift too when they ring up and they might have all sorts of troubles or needs or things to be sorted out, and also to have a friendly voice and a real welcome. I think that's one of the things that we can do, isn't it, in this period? And staying connected and also showing people in so many ways that they matter. We are connected. There are lots of troubles in the world and lots of anxieties across the world, but together
we can do it.
We can do it. Exactly.
There is a bright side.
There's a bright side. That's right. There is a bright side. There's a warm side.
It is.
It's great. So this giving everyone a lift in this period of the Ascension. So we're working out ways that we can do that together. So happy Ascension, everyone. Looking forward to Pentecost and the Spirit of God moving amongst God's people, and also giving us all a lift in this period. So again, it's great to be here at St Matthew's, and to everyone who's been helping, a very, very warm thank you to each one of you. Thanks so much. Thank you. Here we go. Now, so this is for our service on Sunday, of course, and this is Greg Seymour with a very long St Matthew's connection.
Hi.
There we are. That's right. And his lovely parents.
Bevan and Cheryl Seymour.
That's right, there you go. And a lovely St Matthew's connection. In fact, I'm sure those two crosses on the gazebo outside St Matthew's, which has been a place for shelter and hospitality, just right next to our memorial garden, that was made by your dad. You know that?
Yes.
Yeah, and also in memory of your grandmother. And her sister, I think.
Yes, yes.
Married in a double wedding at St Matthew's.
That's correct.
Yeah, in the 1930s, I think.
I'm not exactly sure, but that sounds
about right. That's right. So there we are. And of course, so Greg is a sparky. So he's in the electrical business, keeping people connected.
That's right.
And keeping them on fire. Is that right?
Well, not on fire.
But powered up.
That's right.
Yeah, so
giving them the light.
Giving them the light. That's sharing the light. That's all it's about, isn't it? So,
that's it.
So wherever we are, of course, whether we're in church, out of church, we're sharing the light, aren't we?
That's right.
Sharing the power.
Thank you.
And sharing the love. Good on you, Greg.
Thanks very much. Cheers.
Bye.
From the fourth chapter of the first letter of St. Peter. Friends, don't be surprised when we find ourselves in hard times. Have faith in God and continue to help others. Don't boss people around and be a good example, like a shepherd looking after his sheep. Trust in God to help us because he cares for us more than we will ever know. God will see us through all that is worrying us. He will strengthen, calm, and support us until we all get safety to the other side. For the word of the Lord, thanks be to God.
This is a reading taken from the first chapter of the Acts of the Apostles, speaking about the ascension of Jesus and waiting for the gift of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost. When Jesus' friends met together, they were worried about the future, and Jesus said, "You will receive power and be connected with me and each other when the Holy Spirit comes to you. You will be my people, the witnesses of my love for everyone, wherever you are in the world." While they were watching, a cloud took him up into heaven and out of their sight. Two angels said, "Why are you just standing around and looking up in the sky?" They went back to Jerusalem, to the room upstairs where they were all staying, and they were praying together, waiting and wondering what would happen next. For the word of the Lord, thanks be to God.
Hello, I'm Susan Lee, Federal Member for Farah. And this is Volunteers Week, where the theme is changing communities, changing lives. Thank you to our volunteers. But it's all of our responsibility to keep our social connections working well through this difficult time. People talk about social distancing, and I prefer to call that physical distancing, because our social relationships and connections and friendships must keep going. And it's not unusual to feel isolated and disconnected. So make sure you reach out when you need help. I use technology, devices, some people prefer an old-fashioned phone call and a wave in the street. But whatever it is, we're all in this together. Stay safe, stay well, and look after each other.
Yeah, I mean, it started now, so I mean, so in about 10 seconds, what's he doing?
Sorry.
What's the sound? So we should be talking.
There we are. We're just talking about the sound being on and the sound being off, weren't we? But of course, that's all about communication, isn't it? Trying to work out what it all means. And one of the ways of being connected and communicating, of course, has been our new street sign. There we are. Which has been really something. You know, it was dedicated by Father Rod Bauer, wasn't it? From Gosford. And we had no idea at the time, just the era we're about to enter, and so how important this sign is. So what do you reckon about this sign, and what do you feel that this sign is doing, really? What's the intent?
Well, I hope it's reflecting something that matches to the community.
Hey. Nearly back to normal. That's us. Nearly back to normal. It's the loveliest thing anyone's ever said, is it? It's the new normal, isn't it?
The new normal.
Yeah. Yeah, so, and the sort of the National Volunteers Week, and of course, and the other themes that we're trying to communicate about St. Matthew's, even though it's closed. Yeah, so the church is closed, but the message, of course, remains to be open. So just wondering what those sort of messages are really. So we'll look at those messages. Of course, the message at the bottom is, of course, saying all welcome, but also the changing message, isn't it, as well? Contemporary stuff, yeah?
Yes.
And what's some of those messages? What do you reckon the sort of messages that people need to hear just at the moment?
Oh, I think the waiting and hope's a good one, because
yeah.
We are all waiting. Yeah. We're waiting for things to get back to more of the normal.
Yes.
And
to
waiting
to
meet together as a church, and we're waiting for the people to be able to go back to work and, you know, recover from this stuff.
Well, I'm really grateful that you've been really just come along at exactly the right time of our lives and able to give us a contemporary, sort of a current and a relevant message. And so we're really appreciating that. And so as people stop by, for friends, stranger, people on the outside and inside, and people on the backside of life also, to be able to see a message which is encouraging and give some hope. So thank you very much, Paul. Thank you. And Annette, there we go.
Our
little team. Thank you very much.
Reply.
Now for a moment, I was going to do a tiny little interview, but it only take about 30 seconds.
Okay? No worries.
Okay, so first we're just keeping on to there, and then looking at this
general
stuff here.
Okay, so what would be the best
thing
to do now, then?
There we are, there, and there's Mark.
No, that's all right. I can just add you to the list and make sure.
Well, here we are at St. Matthew's in the Nerve Centre, Ground Zero, the office. And we're just trying to work out ways of being connected, aren't we? And trying to get this computer to speak to this computer. That'd be something. And also for ways that we can be connected with the outside world when the church is closed.
Mm.
So Damien's here. There we are. I'm out at the moment. with his expertise and, of course, one of our church wardens, the everlasting Mark Carden, and the head of our pastoral team. There we are. Annette, and she's talking to people, trying to work out how we can be connected, people who haven't received any messages from St. Matthew since Easter. So we're getting that sorted out as well. So this is a great theme, of course, Ascension, headed on to Pentecost, working out how we can be connected when we're physically distant. And so we're just trying to do that at the moment. And for St. Matthew's, all those people who are trying to help us be connected with so much that's going on around, thank you very much. And of course, if you have any great ideas about being connected, or if you haven't been in touch, if there's some little glitch in your own system, please let us know and be in touch, because, you know, we are a pub, we're not alone. Thanks a lot. Cheers, Ed. Cheers. No worries. Matthews is still closed because of coronavirus. There are certain things that are well and truly open. And so one of those things that are open, of course, is our care for the homeless and the needy, and particularly as the weather is getting colder. And this week we're thinking about the Ascension and also looking forward to the time of Pentecost. The Ascension when, of course, Jesus was raised up to heaven and was physically distant from his friends, and trying to work out what that means to be physically distant but still a part of the same team, connected in a special way. And one of the ways that we are connected at St. Matthew's with our community and all that we've been doing for the 160 years probably since we've been open is to help those who are in need. And so doing it in our own day. And here, we're lifting some things up just now, aren't we? So there's Graham. There we are. We're lifting up the help, lifting up these things that Graham's brought as well. And many other people also have contributed to, as you can see around the place. These are towels, warm clothing, and also all sorts of food that people need. So again, those things don't lift up by magic. They don't appear all by themselves. It is because of the spirit of love and generosity that God has promised that he will send to his people that's still active today. And so we're really very grateful indeed. And so as we see these things, we're reminded that the spirit of God, love of God, the action of God has not just a real purpose, but a real presence in our community even today. So thank you very much to Graham.
Cheers.
Cheers. And also to those who are preparing at the moment for a reopening of our op shop, and also those who work every day to assist those in need. So thank you for those who help St Matthew's, St Matthew's Crisis Care, and also all that we do in our great community as we reach out to others in the name of the love of God. And thank you so much.
And keep warm.
And keep warm, that's right. As we come together today on these days, we think about the Ascension and looking forward to Pentecost, we pray for all those who wait in hope. We remember the concerns of those in our own community and those across the world, those in the parish family of St Matthew's, Albury, for those in our diocese and across the world, all who seek to follow in the way of Christ. To touch with God's love the brokenhearted, to heal, to reassure those who work for justice, and to assist the oppressed, giving thanks for every act of mercy, those who reach out with special love in these challenging days. We lift to God those in our hearts, those on earth, and those in heaven. And we join our prayers with people everywhere in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Aha, there they are. So, but St. Matthew's is still closed. The gates are locked because of the coronavirus. And also the church itself is closed. We're not having services there at the moment, because St. Matthew's always says that all people are welcome, and that means everyone, and that's at all times. So until we're all welcome, then we're all shut up for the sake of our community. But that doesn't mean that our emergency care is shut up, and it's really important that for people whose lives have been closed down for a long time, some of them, that they realise that there's somewhere that they can go for help. And so with very strict protocols, with all these things that are around here, which are quarantined, of course. We've got quarantined. What do we have here, David? And Mary Lou. There we are. And Vicky.
We have a collection of blankets, towels, warm stuff, gloves, socks, jocks, that sort of thing.
Yeah,
and we have a number of sleeping bags for those who need them.
Isn't that terrific?
And bed linen as well.
And also there's emergency food relief, which will continue. We've been doing that, of course, for many, many years. And people sometimes think that we only do those things at Christmas, but of course we know. And actually the people who are really hurting, they also know they've been continuing to come here. So isn't it great that the word is out, that at St. Matthew's there's always help available, regardless of what's going on. So it is terrific, but it's also a challenge.
Yes.
Because they come out every day, and we're able to give them help every day, but sometimes the cupboard is looking fairly bare. So we are connected. This period of ascension and towards Pentecost, when Jesus' community were wondering how they could be together, how they could continue to retain their identity, but while they were away from him, they were, of course, united by the spirit of love. And that's exactly what we're doing here at St. Matthew's. And sometimes that spirit is quite challenging. It rocks our boat and everyone else's. But it is wonderful to think that we care where it really matters. That is, care in ways that anyone can understand, particularly those people who are in need. So thank you very much, everyone, for helping. And we need your help. The weather, of course, is turning. It's become very unfriendly. In fact, it's even cold in here. Look at that. One light bulb. That's it. It's not very warm, but we've got a great lot of warm ideas as we're preparing to reopen our op shop as well. And we're ramping up our assistance to those people just when the weather's really getting colder. So thank you very much, everyone, for doing what you're doing and continue doing it. Okay, thanks a lot. Bye.
Good morning, everyone. I hope you've enjoyed our service this morning, and thank you to all those people who've contributed to this service. Our doors remain closed, our gates are locked, until such time as we can welcome everybody back, because that's what we do at St. Matthew's, everybody is welcome. We won't be opening the doors again. Thank you to all those people who've set up a direct deposit, and to those people who've donated towards keeping the church going at this time. Our good news today is that we will reopen the op shop on June the 1st. It will be with reduced hours from 10 till 2, and we'll do a trial and see how it goes. We are in need of some warm, good quality warm clothes for men and for women, even for children. If you're able to contribute with those clothes, can you give us a call? We can come down and open the office up. We will be quarantining the clothes for 48 hours, as St. Vinny's has said they're going to do. And then we'll be having the op shop open on Monday the 1st of June. Evensong. Evensong at St. Matthew's is always the first Sunday of the month. And we haven't had many first Sundays of the month in the last couple of months. Sounds a bit funny, doesn't it? But on the 7th of June, which will be the first Sunday of June, we'll be televising an Evensong that was quite a spectacular one from last year. So tune in for 5 p.m. That day you'll have a 9 a.m. service and a 5 p.m. service. Thanks again, everybody, for your support. It's very much appreciated.